The movie begins with John Brickner being released on parole. He spent 4 years in prison out of the total sentence, which was 7 years. Because of his exemplary behavior and the guilt he carried for killing a man, he was released on parole. John moves to Seattle and gets a new job as a construction worker. At night, John goes to the bar and notices that the waitress is being harassed by two men. John attacks one of the men and asks him to apologize to the girl, and then kicks him out of the bar. John's behavior impresses the bar owner, who offers him a job. Indeed, John got a second job as a bouncer at the bar. We watch John being treated badly as a construction worker by a boss. In the bar, a fight occurs between two men, so John breaks up the fight and expels the people who fought. Because of John's power, someone comes to John and offers him a job, but John refuses. One day, while working on a construction site, the wife of the man killed by John approaches, and her name is Veronica. She informs John that she has applied for parole. John thanks Veronica, but she tells him that she didn't because of the messages John was sending her. She did this because she has an 8-year-old daughter who needs a heart transplant. She blames John for killing her husband. She asks John to pay the $250,000 surgery fee. John goes to his room and counts some of the money he got from his work and keeps it in the ventilation hole. That night, while the bar waitress is trying to get John to count the money he got, John asks her how to find the person who offered him a job that day. She takes him to a man named Reno. It transpires to John that Reno is directing fighters to participate in legitimate fighting competitions. When John finds out about the job, he refuses to join. Reno tries to convince John to stay by telling him that he can get a lot of money for his participation in the fight. One day at the workplace, the work manager fires John from work, even though John was working hard and sincerely. Suddenly, the principal suffers a heart attack, and John saves him while the paramedics arrive. That night, he goes to Veronica and tells her that he cannot pay for her daughter's surgery. Veronica starts yelling at John and shows him the letters John wrote to her while he was in prison. Her daughter Sarah comes because of the loud voice, so her mother asks her to go back to bed. But Sarah introduces her doll to John, which makes John feel pity for her. John tells Veronica that he will try to help her. John visits the fighting ring and was able to participate and fight in his first fight as a replacement for a participant who lost consciousness during the fight. John manages to defeat the man despite being bitten. Then John shares the money he got with the other person who lost consciousness because he helped him get this money. The next day, when John returns home, he finds Reno and Frankie in his room. They ask John to participate in more fights because he is making money for them, and they were in need of money. Then they go to talk to another person named Deacon, who is an investor, and Reno wanted him to give John a chance to participate in the battles because he is good. But Deacon says no one can trust John and that there is no long-term guarantee. John asks to speak privately with Deacon. John tells Deacon he will get the money. A man named Nestor comes to Reno, where Reno owed this guy money. Nestor orders his men to kill Reno, but John intervenes and agrees with Nestor to fight, and the loser will pay $10,000. Nestor agrees. A fight begins between John and one of Nestor's men. They were fighting and surrounded by a group of dogs that would bite any man who approached them. The fight is very fierce, but John wins. And now John and Reno have enough money to go and meet Deacon. John gets a call from Veronica. Frankie sees the name of the caller on John's phone and asks him about it. Frankie tells John about her relationship with Reno and how Reno saved her life, but John isn't interested in that, and instead John asks Frankie about what Reno pawned. Later, John visits Veronica in the hospital. Sarah's condition was going well, but her health deteriorated and she was taken to the hospital. John tells Veronica that he is working hard to get money for Sarah. Veronica tries to be patient, and John tells her that he will work for the money. At Reno's house, Frankie remembers the name of a person to help them, but Reno asks her to wait because they have barely got rid of his problem with Nestor. But Frankie sympathizes with John and tells Reno that John is not a money changer. John gets angry at Frankie's words and tells her that John had killed a man in the past and that's why he was in prison. John asks Frankie if she thinks John is one of the good guys. He tells her that they need the money to pay off their debts. John overhears their entire conversation but is unaffected by it. Later, John participates in multiple fights and wins all of them. John returns to Frankie's house alone and asks her about her skill with the needle and asks her why she didn't go to medical school. Meanwhile, while Reno was playing with his friends, Val's men approached him and took him out of the building, beat him hard, and ordered him to pay $250,000, which is the amount he owed to Val. They threatened to harm Frankie if he did not pay the amount within the specified period. Then Reno sets up a fight between John and one of Nestor's men, and it's a tough fight. John takes several blows, prompting Frankie to try to stop the fight. But John doesn't back down and with Reno's encouragement manages to knock his opponent down. Later during the celebration, Reno says they still have to wait. And then an emergency call comes to John from Veronica. John quickly goes to Veronica's apartment. When John arrives, he finds a letter from Veronica telling him that her request was rejected by the donor. And then John finds her trying to end her life in the bathroom, so John quickly takes her to the hospital. In the waiting room, Frankie asks John about Veronica, and he tells her the whole story. John notices scars on Frankie's wrist, which indicates that Reno saved Frankie's life one day when she attempted suicide. John meets Veronica and tells her that she must not give up. She tells him that she should have given her heart to her daughter Sarah, but John promises her that he will get the money. Reno arranges a fight for John, betting $250,000. Val's men lock Reno in the bathroom, but he promises to give them money after the fight is over. Frankie watches the men and is upset with Reno for not telling her what he is up to. The fight begins, and John defeats his opponent, but Nestor wants the battle to be to the death, but John refuses and loses. Frankie comes to hug John while Reno is brutally beaten by Val's men. On their way back, John discovers that Reno owes money to a guy named Val. John tells Frankie that she should have told him. Reno tells John it's not his problem. One day, while John is eating, he notices a car that has been watching him for days. John gets in the car and they drive him to an old man. The man tells John that since John saved his brother-in-law while he was working as a construction worker, this man owes him a debt. John tells the man that he needs money to perform a heart transplant for a girl named Sarah. It becomes clear to John that this person is Val, to whom Reno owes money. Val offers John two options. The first option is for him to pay off Reno's debts or for this man to help John get the money for Sarah. John chooses to help Reno. John takes Veronica home, and Veronica begins to tell her life story, telling John that her daughter is her greatest achievement. John tells her that he did not mean to kill her husband and that it was in self-defense. John visits Deacon, but the Deacon tells John he can't help him. John returns to his home and packs his things. Then Reno arrives and thanks John for helping him pay off his debts. Frankie tells John how Reno saved her by paying off her debts. Reno takes his call that a fight has been scheduled. A fight begins after being pushed by an unknown person. Everyone gets excited and starts fighting, and it turns out to be the hardest fight. When John and his opponent fell to the ground, it was revealed that John was dead, but he was covered in some material. When John stands up, he asks them if they can finish, but John ends up winning the battle. Veronica gets a donor for her daughter and saves her daughter's life. John returns the sleeves of Reno's father to him, as John bought it for him. Then Reno and John hugged and everything was fine.